Hi, this is Sunita. I'm going to explain you about procedures and stack. Before procedure, if you want to use procedures in your program, you have to consider one thing. You have to declare stack segment in your program. So what is the necessity of declaring the stack segment in your program? I will explain you later. First of all, I will explain what is meant by stack and what is the use of stack and where you can use the stack. So the stack is a section of memory you set aside for storing return addresses, contents of registers and temporary results. And the size of the stack can be up to 64 kilobyte segment. Entire 64 kilobytes you can use as a stack, and it is a data structure called as last in first out data structure. That means last in first out data structure means the item that enters last into the stack is the item that comes out of the stack first. Okay, and I already told you, you have to initialize, you have to do some program additions when using the stack. So what is the required program addition when using the stack or when using the procedure in your program means you have to use this part of the code. So here you are declaring one stack. The name of the stack is stack segment, and you are initializing 40 words, and you are initializing all those 40 words into zero, and you are using stack top label word to initialize the top address of the stack, and here the stack segment ends. And in the code segment, if you see, you are initializing the SS register, stack segment base register with the address of stack segment, and you are loading the address of the stack top into stack pointer register. That means this segment and this part of the code is required to initialize the stack segment base register SS and as well as stack pointer register SP. So SS and SP are used combinedly to access a stack. So you can access stack using base register as well as offset register SP. So this is how you can initialize stack segment when you are going to use procedure in your main program. And there are different types of operations you can perform on stack. And coming to here, if you see, you declared 40 words of stack size. So that means it starts at location 80,000 and ends at location 4FH. These are total 80 locations. 40 words means each word consists of 2 bytes. So 40 into 2, 80 bytes. So here the stack segment ends. And what you have to do here means top of the stack must be initialized with the address next to the stack segment, and later whenever you are going to do push or different operations on stack, it will help you to use the memory effectively. Okay, this is the start of the stack segment, and you always have to initialize the stack pointer to the top of the stack. And next, coming to the operations you can perform on stack are push and pop operations. Always these operations are word operations. And if you consider the push operation, what are the sequences of steps followed when push operation is executed means decrements the stack pointer by 2 and writes the specified register contents or memory location contents to the top of the stack. Okay, and next, coming to the pop operation, it copies a word from the top of the stack to the specified 16-bit register or memory location and increments the stack pointer by 2. And push and pop operations are reversed to each other. Here you are decrementing the stack pointer contents by 2, and here in pop you are incrementing the stack pointer contents by 2. And coming to the stack segment, when push and pop operations are performed, here I am going to use one example called push AX, and you are trying to push AX register into the stack, and you are trying to pop back the AX register contents again into the AX register. And first, if you see here, initially the top of the stack is pointing to 8005H location, and if you try to push AX into the stack, what happens means first AX, top SP contents gets decremented by 1, and top of the stack now points to 4FH location, and AH contents get stored at this location, and next again the stack pointer contents gets decremented by 1, and now at 8004EH AL contents get stored at this location, and now the top of the stack is pointing here after the push AX instruction. And now if you try to pop AX register contents, initially it is pointing here, and first what happens means first AL register the contents that are present at this location are loaded into AL register, and the stack pointer contents gets incremented by one, and now it is pointing here to 8004FH, and now pops back the contents present over here to the AH register, and again the stack pointer contents gets incremented by one, and now the stack pointer is pointing to 8005H. That means if you see here, top of the stack is pointing to 80050 before push instruction and after the pop AX instruction. Okay, so this is how you can understand the stack operation with the help of push and pop operations, and initial stack startup segment is at 80,000 location. Okay, and next coming to the procedure. Procedure is like a function in high level language. So when you want to use a particular sequence of instructions in your program multiple times, you can use procedures. That means you need not have to write so many times the same set of instructions in your program. Why? Because it increases the length of your program. So instead of writing the same sequence of instructions multiple times, you can use a concept called procedure. You can call that procedure multiple times in your program, and you can implement that procedure by using call and return instruction. And call followed by a procedure name calls the procedure, and return instruction at the end of the procedure brings back the control to the mainline program. So whenever a procedure is called, the control transfers from the mainline program to the procedure, and after executing the particular set of instructions in the procedure, it has to again come back to the mainline program. So to come back to the mainline program, return instruction helps to transfer the control from procedure to mainline program. And procedure is placed with a segment called PROC, and NDP directives, assembler directives are used to define a procedure. And coming to the types of a procedure, okay, so there are two types of procedures: near procedure and far procedure. So if the procedure is situated in the same core segment as then it is called as near procedure, and if the procedure is situated outside the current code segment, then it is called as far procedure. So procedure is implemented, already I told you, with the help of call instruction. So what happens when a near procedure is called? What are the how call instruction gets executed and how the control transfers back to the mainline program? I will explain with the help of diagram. So near procedure and stack, here if you see, so here the start of the stack segment is 90,000H, and stack top is pointing to 90,050H, and SP is initially pointing here before the call instruction. And whenever a procedure is called, so you are calling a procedure, so what happens after the call instruction, you have immediate instruction. That instruction has some address. So after executing the procedure, the control must transfer to the next instruction immediately after the call instruction, that is placed in the next instruction address is placed in the IP register. So you have to push those IP register contents into the stack before when you call a procedure. So whenever you call a procedure, it will immediately push the IP high and IP low register contents into the stack. When this is about near procedure. So near procedure means the procedure is residing within the same code segment. So that's why no need to load the CS and CS register contents. You have to load only IP register contents. IP register contents address of the next instruction in the program. Okay. So ikkada, so here SP points here after call. Okay. So this is about near procedure. And when you complete the sequence of operations in the procedure, again when you encounter return, the stack pointer points to the top of the stack like this. And next, coming to the for procedure. So whenever for procedure is called, that means the procedure is outside the current code segment. So you are jumping to another code segment. So that's why you have to load CS high and CS low also into the stack top, and IPI high and IP low. So after the call, here it is pointing, and SP points before call and after return heap. Return instruction again comes to the top of the stack like this. Okay, this is about a for procedure and near procedure. And coming to the passing parameters to procedure, you can pass parameters to procedure using registers, dedicated memory locations with pointer passed in registers and with stack. So whenever you want to pass more number of parameters, you can use pointers. And whenever limited number of operands you want to pass, you can use register. Why? Because register size is limited. And dedicated memory locations, if you use, it has got the drawback of whenever you change the location contents, it gets reflected here in the mainline program. And stack is also having some advantage. And depending on the scenario, you can use one of these ways to pass parameters to this procedure. And what is the advantage of using the procedure means, it is instantiated only once in memory, even though you can call multiple times in your program. And debugging you can also do for one time, no need to debug every time whenever you call a procedure. These are the advantages of procedures. So I'm stopping here, expecting a clear view of stack and procedures and return and call instructions.